Okay, I'll take you through a journey about a quite important project about improving utilization of density for minor head injury in pediatric age group in our FCH cover. As all of us know, the quality improvement project, we should first class study about our situation, and after that we will plan for change, and we'll do it, and again we will study what improvement we did, and we will act according to improve. So we did around three PDSA cycles through our project. Our background that the incidence of death from head injury is low, and long-term disability and it can cause a lot of complication. So our rule is early detection of and treatment of life-threatening brain injury and the early discharge of patient with a negligible risk of brain injury. But in the same time, we prevent crowding in the emergency department and decrease the radiation exposure. So while CTs can carry an important role in identification of clinically significant intracranial injuries, also they have the risk of radiation. So we did our initial audits of clinical notes, and we did survey of the physician. We revealed that around 45% of systems in pediatric are not indicated. And in 36% there were issues with documentation. So our project goal is clear that we want to decrease the number of unindicated CT head to around 20% and improve emergency department physician documentation by the end of November 2015. We did the fish bone to search for the cause, why we are behind. So we did this for fish bone for quality to see what's the problem with policies or procedure or the people or plan. And we did a survey to as a Pareto analysis to see what is the main cause. We found that around 80%, more than 80% related to the guideline itself. So we want to target the guideline itself. So we make tasks, we arrange our team, me, myself, and Waleed, Jalal, Dr. Ahmed from radiology, Qub, and Sharif Tahti, Dr. Stephen, and our godfather, Dr. Sharif Farouk, our godfather of the project, and Dr. Suresh. And we have will assign the timetable, and we stuck to it clearly, and alhamdulillah we succeeded. I hope. We did the discussion during the start. We found this the last updated NICE guideline in January 2014, which has a clear criteria when to perform CT. If we have one criteria of these, we'll do CT. If we have two criteria of these, we'll do CT and we'll consider warfarin. So we searched more, and when Prof. Stephen entered, he opened a lot of mind. So we searched out for CATCH and CHALLENGE and PICARD. This is the three biggest study in the pediatric head injury. And the main one is PICARD. We found that it has a sensitivity around 100% below 2 years and around 96% sensitivity above 2 years to detect clinically important brain injuries. And the big study in 2014, this comparison of PICARD and CATCH and CHALLENGE. And we found this, they wanted to evaluate the diagnostic accuracy of the C3 studies, and they found, and among the around 1,000 children, they found the sensitivity for PICARD reached around 100% to exclude the significant brain injury by physician practice or PICARD itself. So we did an audit in 2014. Our aim to evaluate our adherence to Hamad General Hospital guidelines, and we compared it with the NICE guidelines, and we found that we did it on 101 patients retrospective in August, and we exclude the ACT done for any other causes, and we searched the radiology database, and we found a lot of results. We put it in data sheet on Excel about this criteria we are searching for in our criteria. And we discovered that a lot of them not documented, and time of CT head was delayed, and the result only 7% was positive. And so something is going wrong. And we found only around the indicated CT only 48%. And we have a clear result that there is clear evidence of physician-based decision, not based on guideline, and we need a new NICE guideline to implement. So, what's the change we did? We did to change the HMC guidelines, and we have acceptance now from the outer population and the stakeholders from radiology, neurosurgery, and neurology. And we did hand out of guidelines, and we did one-to-one shop floor education, and we did regular education sessions, and also in the seminar in immersion. This HMC guidelines, me and Larissa did it, and it is accepted from our emergency and Dr. Shaza, and now in the corporation. And this is the algorithm that Dr. Stephen did, and he took all the acceptance of the all stakeholders, and this is the simplified cards for to be very simple. It is very simple to know. So I did by myself and all colleagues one-to-one education. This is the proof. This is my field. Okay. And the card between your hands is very simple and it can apply clearly. And we'll see to all discussions or questions. Okay. One more. And we did another audit in January and February 2015 to search for the same causes, for the same points. And we found that the result of CT increased for the positive, and we found that indicated CT increase indicated 36% was indicated, and the CT result was 21% positive, increase only who did CT. And we did comparison and the main results now before and after intervention, and we found this indicated CT, we decreased the number of CT done from 32 to 22. And we decreased increase the indication of CT from 26 to 36, and we had the deficient documentation decreased, so increased documentation from 36 to 23. Our conclusion, managing minor head injury in the left age group become more safe by increasing patients' awareness and easy their access to updated evidence-based clinical decision rules and guidelines. And for sustainability, we want to continue with this cards in your hands. We are doing posters everywhere in our emergency. We have checklists, minimum checklists, and guidelines and algorithms. And we have a regular audit every 3 months, and we do regular education sessions, and alhamdulillah, did more. And we want to put it as big usual and quality indicator. This is our reference, and I want to share with you some success we did. We presented this poster in the International Conference Middle East Forum on Quality and Safety in Healthcare in Qatar, and we have oral presentation in the second annual Emergency Medicine Symposium, and we did that oral presentation also in the seminar. And we now, today, 8th December, we have accepted and it is announced there the poster for 22nd Annual Forum Quality Improvement Healthcare in Orlando, Florida. Now we are. We have also acceptance in new presentation in our big festival in Iceland.
Is this some kind of mafia or
anything? No, but for the kids, maybe 1 year and a half. Yeah.
On my issues as well. I've got, a very important question. As a result of your intervention, have you had any critical incidents where a child who was supposed to have had a scan did not get a scan and then came to us? This is a question. Any quality improvement project we need to be asking. So did you look at your data to see there are any banks, maybe confident enough to assure someone like Celine, she got a complaint that someone's got scams.
Did now
got that process built in via QR?
Yes, it did in our QI, and we did audit to search for this issue, and alhamdulillah didn't happen at all in our department. And also for regular auditing, we will search for it. And nobody...
So I'm going to figure out a little bit more on that.
Yes.
So how did you conclude that there were no incidents? What sort of data did you look at?
That we searched for all patients that had CT for them in our emergency. So if even if the second visit, we will search for the first visit.
Yes.
If we did it done based on this guideline, we will see. If there is nothing, no case discharged home according to the guideline, and return again in that city and found any significantly important brain, traumatic brain injury.
So did you check the complaints and the critical incident database to see if there was any such incident before you applied?
No.
So I think that's a suggestion at your next business cycle.
Yeah, I agree.
Are you happy with the results you've achieved?
I think I'm happy, alhamdulillah, but I want to make regular auditing every 3 months. I did education, alhamdulillah, in our gathering joint activity and fellowship and residency. And one-to-one education, but we want more to maintain sustainability. So I think they will forget.
The augmentation is still high efficiency in that.
Yeah.
You've got a number of new doctors.
I tried to fix this by the checklist, and I discussed to enter in the seminar. They promised me that we will enter the seminar. That will be a checklist, it is easy. The seminar for any pediatric patient like this injury, we will take this checklist and it will be committed to 100% sure.
And that's a good suggestion. In the meantime, I think the posters, the one that you suggested, be a good idea, because book posters in the pediatric audience. Everybody comes, they can just look at it, and it would be easy to explain even to parents. So, This is why you're doing. So, yeah. That will be a good one. Otherwise, it was good. Very important question. Your outcome depends on this. It's my day in Florida this morning, smiling at everybody.
Yes.
So, who is presenting?
We didn't go as we have a system.
You read not
December. Okay, thank you.